developers, talking to some folks from Shodogg. This is Herb Bitchley and Seth Green. Can you guys tell me a little bit about what your product does?
Sure, absolutely. We're a media technology that enables any smartphone to wirelessly direct any streaming content to any web-enabled device without wires or boxes.
Great. Now, Seth, you're an advisor for the company. Makes you interested in Shodogg?
Well, this is, it seems like a simple idea that nobody has done before, and it's just a resolution for the audience to be able to display their media and control their media amongst any device they want. So any phone that you want, any tablet that you want, any television that you want, as long as it's enabled, you can send your media to that for exhibition. So instead of watching something on your phone, you can go to a friend's house and watch it on their TV.
Now, could I start watching it at home and then watch it somewhere else?
Yeah, that's actually part of that. That's part of the program. So you can have you consider it? So you can throw stuff to one monitor, and then you can even fetch it back.
Fetch and toss.
Yeah, fetch and toss, and then that allows you
keeping your place in the movie.
It's portable. Yeah.
Really? That's
look,
great.
The most important thing is that the content owner, it's their file, it's their media player, it's their advertising. So there's no downside for them. We are literally delivering the user to where the content exists today.
There's no violation of copyright. There's no piracy. It's the same exchange that the content provider has with any other service, except it gives the user the ability to display it when they want.
Okay. So this is an app.
It's an app.
Essentially, yeah.
Yep.
Absolutely.
Okay.
And there's two ways we can work. It's our own app, which allow anybody who owns content to upload it and actually create a channel within Shodogg. Mm-hmm. Or if you're a larger network and you want to be the front face, you can use our very unique overlay system and have all the same functionality, but you're the front face. So there's two ways to work it.
That is one of the best things to explain is that the app provides an overlay for any service. So if you've got a Netflix or an HBO Go, this works on top of it. You don't have to open up each of those applications individually. You would simply go to Shodogg, and that would open up each one of those interfaces. You could pull content from any one of those applications through this application.
That's a nice feature.
Yeah, it's just simple, ease, convenience. That's what it's all about.
So is this still in development? Is it out yet?
It's in development. March will be our consumer app, and then around June, July of this year, we'll open up our SDK and allow anybody who owns content to take our SDK and upload their content using our technology, create a channel, and get a lot more eyeballs on a large screen, which is really difficult because it's expensive to get to that screen. We increase your footprint for a fraction of the cost.
Well, what kind of cost are we talking?
It's free for the consumer.
That's the best cost.
Absolutely.
So have you guys had a chance to walk around the show floor at all?
A little bit. I haven't gotten to see too many things. Mostly convenience items, like tablet stands, or what did we see? We saw some massage chairs. I'm more interested in the robots, but there seems to be a deficit of robot technology at the show.
I did see a cool iRobot last night.
I saw that too. I'm still waiting for the service stuff that they have in Japan.
Right. So anything kind of catch your interest tonight? Or?
A bunch of nice cell phone cases. Some of the cool stuff.
Great. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay, so Seth, you know everyone's really excited that you're here.
Oh, thanks.
You know, I'm excited because of Buffy.
Oh, I love that show.
I love that show. And Robot Chicken, how's that going?
It's going really well. We made 100 episodes. Our 100th episode actually airs this coming Sunday.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much. And then we're in production right now. We're making a DC Comics special to start the 60s, and then we'll start the 60s right after that.
Really? And when is that coming out?
It'll probably be summertime, I guess.
Great.
We're working on it now. It's a long lead time.
Congratulations. I'll be looking forward.